Hello guys, my name is Kishan and today we are going to talk about global temporary tables in Oracle. So what are temporary tables and how are they different from regular tables? Well, a temporary table stores temporary data. It is called as global temporary table, but the table over here is not temporary. The data in the table is temporary. So when we say temporary, it means like the data in the global temporary table will exist only as long as the session or the transaction exists. At the end of the session or transaction, all the data gets deleted. So data in the GTTs are private for every session. Yes, if a new user is connecting if you are connecting from the same user from multiple places, even then the data in the GTT as session specific, it will not be shared between the same users different sessions also. But the table definition can be viewed by all the sessions. Now why we use GTT? Basically GTT gives some performance improvement. And how do they give performance improvement is like, the data in the GTT is stored in temporary table space. Okay, the default temporary table space, whichever the Oracle is currently using, in that table space, GTT's data will be stored. And a temporary table space, as we all know, is not protected by redo log generation. So we decrease the amount of logs that are generated, and hence we increase our performance. But there is indirect redo log generations. Why? Because whenever we update data in the GTT, you know, the undo table space, the data is stored in the undo table space, whatever the updated data is there and all. And this undo table space is again, you know, protected by redo log generations. So there is an indirect redo log generations in GTT. If you don't want to get into the working of a GTT or how Oracle uses this information is not much relevant. We will just look into how we can create a GTT and how we can use it in our day-to-day codes. But this is the basic background of how a GTD would work. Your data is stored in a temporary table space. After 11G, from onwards of 11G, Oracle has even made an enhancement in the GTD syntax that you can give the name of temporary table space in which you want the data for that table to be stored. Okay, so that way. And now coming to the uses of GTD. So as I said, it would improve your performance a bit. Okay. And GTDs are helpful in working with complex queries. You know, sometimes we'll be working like we have some data which is then converted to a complex set, and then from that set, intermediate set, it is converted to the final output. So you might be having some data and you might have you know, modified it in such a way that that modified data is again by used by some other queries, and then you get the final output. So when you do all these things, it is time consuming as well as slow. But if you use GTT in this place where you are storing your intermediate data into a table and then, you know, querying from that table and updating in that table and finding a final output, so the performance would get increased over there. It's an alternative to the with as clause which we use with select statements. And also the basic advantage we get is like we get that table kind of a feel. Okay, we insert into the table, we update the data, we delete the data, and we have all the advantages of a table. Like we can create an index, we can create a view on a GTT, we can have triggers, explain plans, and you know, we can know the information about the rows and blocks of the data as we can know about the normal table. So we get all these benefits which we don't get when we use an with as clause or some other form of, you know, temporary storage. Also GTT's table definition can be exported and imported. Of course, not the data. The data is very much session specific. And the drawback is like you can't have foreign keys related to temporary tables. Actually, there are much more restrictions, version specific restrictions in GTTs. So let's look at the syntax of a global temporary table. It's mostly same as a create table statement. Like it's like over here we have create global temporary table name. Then we would have column definition. That would be like our column name and the data type, comma, column name, data type. And we have one more new add-on clause, that is on commit. When you give on commit, you are specifying what should happen with the data when a commit happens for that table. Okay, when a commit happens for that session. So we say like on commit, either you can delete the rows That is whenever a commit is applied, your rows get deleted. Okay, and the other is on commit preserve rows. When you say preserve rows, the rows will be preserved, but for only that session. As soon as the session is ended abruptly or by doing an exit, whatever way, the data will again get lost. That's why these are temporary tables. You know, the data in it is not persistence. It is only specific to that session. And then at the last, we have not log on rollback delete rows stair clause. By default, it is a not logged on rollback delete rows. That is, you know, when a rollback is applied, the rows get deleted. So now let's get into the development or how to create a GTD and how to use it and all. So over here, I'm connected to the HR session of Oracle. So what I'll do is I'll create a GTD. So I'll write create global temporary table and I'll give a name. Let me give, say, suppose GTT underscore country. Okay, I'll have two columns in it. One is country name, that is like vacare to say 30, and I'll also have something called as country ID. So let me give number data type over here. So here I have created a table, written a table such as create global temporary table, table name. Then I have two columns in it, and now comes our clause of on commit. Now on commit, what I want to do is I'll just delete rows. Okay, and execute it. For the HR schema, the global temporary table has been created. Okay, so when you do something like select staff from, currently it is empty, GTT underscore country, say suppose. As you can see, there is no data present in this table over here. Fine. Now I'll just show the definition, how it is, you know, stored in the database. You go into tables, I'll just refresh it once, and you can find our GTT underscore table. Where it is, yeah. As you can see here, it shows a small envelope kind of a thing, stating like it is a GTT table. Go in SQL here, you can see the statement. It says create global temporary table, table name, the our columns and data types, and it says on commit delete rows. So I'll just see how this on commit delete rows would work. I'll just insert some value into this table. Okay, let me insert like 100 for India. Okay, and now I'll insert two more records, and then we'll commit the data and see what happens. Okay, so let me take 101 as Canada, 102 as USA, and now I'll just execute it. As we can see, three rows are inserted. Now when I query this table, you can find that there is country ID 100, 101, 102, all this data present in this HR schema. Okay, and I'll just commit the data. And I have given on commit delete rows, right? So I am now committing this data. When I commit it and when I query the table back, as you see, the data is deleted. This is what happens. As we have stated, on commit delete rows, it will take it transaction specific, and as soon as a commit is executed, all the data is deleted. Okay, now let me just delete this, drop this table, and I'll make something like on commit preserve rows, and let's see how it works. Okay, so drop table, table name. As you can see, I just executed drop table instead of drop temporary table, and it worked. I've just changed it to on commit preserve rows. I've created the table. As you can see, it's empty. I'll insert some records into it. Now let me commit it. Say it is committed. Now I went select staff from, when I select from the table, as you can see, the data is present. What happens is when I did an on commit preserve rows, the when a commit was executed, the data is still present in the table, in the global temporary table. It is not deleted, how as it was in the case of on commit delete rows. So when does the data in this on commit preserve rows global temporary table gets deleted? Simple, when you end the session, whether abruptly or you know you do a simple exit. When I will do something like, let me just disconnect this over here. Fine, I have disconnected. Okay, now let me connect it again. It seems it is connected. Now when I query this table back, see nothing is present in this table. So on commit preserve rows will get cleaned up, or all the data in the table or global temporary table will get deleted when the session is ended. That becomes a session specific data. You can also update and delete and do all those kind of stuffs on the GTT. Now one more thing, even when your global temporary table, when you create it, let me just drop it again, let me just create it again. I'll just insert some data into this table. I'll commit it. Now what I'll do is I'll create one more session. I'll open one more session. As you can see, this is another, I'm trying to open another session over here for that very same schema name. And now if I try to check the data in this new session, let me show you that in the old session we have some data. See, you have 100, 101, 102 data present in this HR session when we have created the global temporary table, inserted some data into it, okay. But when I change, when I create a new session and I try to query the very same table, okay, no data is present. So even for the same user, for the same schema, in the separate session of that schema, you will not be able to find that data. So global temporary tables are very much session specific. You can see that we have got the table definition. We can see that there is no record present in something called as country ID, country name. So it found out that there is a table present with the global temporary table present with the name of GTT country. So the definition of the table is retrieved, but not the data. Okay, so please remember this, that even for the same schema, if there are multiple sessions, the global temporary table's data will only be visible for a session in which the data is inserted or manipulated or updated, not in other schemas. You will find the definition of the table, but not the data. So this is how we work with global temporary tables. What we have seen today is how to create a global temporary table, how to delete it. The insert, update, delete of row in a GTT is as common as doing it with normal tables. We have seen on commit delete rows. That is when a commit is executed, all the rows get deleted. It becomes a transaction specific. And we have seen on commit preserve rows. In that case, when a commit is executed, the data is preserved till the session is in place. As soon as the session is ended, the data is not visible. Also, in any case, you will not be able to see a data of a GTT in other sessions other than in what it was created. Okay, and we have seen the storage of GTT are taken place in undo table space and temporary table spaces. So this is all what we have covered in this video. I hope this video was informative and you guys enjoyed this. Please do like, share and subscribe. Please do communicate in the comment section. This is Kishan signing off. Thank you.